Now we are going to recognize the coffee maker. And now we have an option to choose a normal coffee or a double coffee. But since I'm cheap, I'm going to use a normal coffee. I'm going to say yes. Now, my phone is going to make the HTTP request and the coffee maker will prepare the coffee. Hi, my name is Tanislav Dimov, and I'm a software developer at Mentoral. Today I'm going to be talking about a rather simple but powerful concept. Nowadays, everyone strives to make his or her life easier. We at Mentoral know that, and we try to help you achieve it by implementing the latest and greatest technologies in the IT sector into the development of our products. In the recent years, technologies like blockchain, augmented reality, and Internet of Things started gaining popularity faster than ever before. And these powerful technologies are still in their infant stages, but we at Mentoral believe in the huge potential they hold. But how can we use them to our advantage? Let's imagine a few scenarios. How many times have you been in a restaurant, ready with your order, but you had to wait for the waitress to come and take it? Imagine being able to walk into the same restaurant and make the order by just looking at the restaurant table. Or perhaps you would want to take a nice bike ride in the park for an hour on Sunday. Imagine being able to walk towards the bike stand and rent a bike by just looking at it or pointing it at your phone. The possibilities are endless, but for the purpose of this demo, why not start with something simple? Why not turn an average, off-the-shelf coffee maker machine into a smart coffee maker machine? Let's take a look at the visual representation of the general idea. Using a blockchain to make financial transactions isn't something new. In fact, this is how a typical purchase of coffee down at your local coffee shop would look like if it were using a blockchain. You, the client, will ask the cashier for a cup of coffee, for which you're going to make a transaction on the blockchain designated for him. And when he receives the right amount of tokens from you, he's going to use the coffee maker to prepare the coffee. Very simple. But now, let's modify our workflow a bit, and let's make it more automated. Here's the same visual representation, but this time, you're going to use your phone's camera. You're going to point it towards the coffee maker. Your phone will then recognize the coffee maker and will prompt you with a menu. The other side, the cashier, is replaced by a coffee providing service. The coffee providing service is going to be listening for transactions designated for it on the blockchain. And when you're ready with your purchase, your phone is going to make a transaction on the blockchain designated for the coffee providing service. And when the coffee providing service receives the right amount of tokens from you, it's going to ask the coffee maker prepare the coffee. Okay, so knowing the general idea, let's take a deeper look at how each of the components work together. But before we start, I would like to point out that this presentation is only presented as a proof of concept. Therefore, the implemented workflow is not final, it is a subject to change. Here's how the actual workflow looks like. But let's take a deeper look at each of the components one by one. First, our Android app. It uses the Unity development platform and Google's AIR Core, and its job is to recognize the coffee maker and to prompt you with a menu. And when you choose your desired beverage, your phone is going to make an HTTP request containing a JSON with all information about it and send it to your whitecode. Of course, since this is only a proof of concept, our whitecode implementation is extremely simple and is intended to be used in a real case scenario. In a real case scenario, that whitecode is going to be replaced by some type of wallet, or perhaps a hardware wallet. In our implementation, our whitenode receives the JSON from the Android app and then forwards it to the full node by making a spend transaction request. Of course, the full node is a trusted node. The full node then prepares a spend transaction, serializes it via AeroP, and encodes it in Base58 in order to be able to send it back in JSON, and then forwards it to the whitenode. The whitenode then receives the AeroP serialized data, decodes it from Base58, and signs it with the sender's private key. It will then encode both the signature and the AeroP serialized data back in Base58 and going to forward them back to the full node. The full node is running on one of our servers. It is considered trusted, and we are going to use it during this demo to mine our blocks. Every time a new block is mined, a full node broadcasts it to a WebSocket on which the coffee provider is going to be listening. Of course, in order for the coffee provider to communicate with the coffee makers, we use an MQTT broker. As you can see from the illustration, the MQTT broker hosts a topic called coffee machine. In it, the publisher, our coffee provider, can post a message for the desired coffee type, and the other side, our subscriber, which is our coffee maker, can receive it and act accordingly. The coffee provider is a middleman between the blockchain and the coffee makers. It knows each coffee maker's public address and listens for transactions designated for those addresses on the blockchain. Every time a new block is mined, our coffee provider goes through each and every one of the transactions and looks for transactions which receiver's addresses are one of the coffee maker's public addresses. If it finds such transactions, it looks at its payload, which is of course the desired coffee type, and then it looks at the amount of tokens sent. If the amount of tokens sent are enough for the desired beverage, it is going to ask the designated coffee maker to prepare the coffee. And last, but not least, our coffee maker, as we discussed previously, is subscribed to the MQTT broker's topic. Every time it receives a message from the coffee provider, it acts accordingly. But I know that you're more excited to see all this in action, so let us, without further ado, go straight to it. Now we are going to recognize the coffee maker, and now we have an option to choose a normal coffee or a double coffee. But since I'm cheap, I'm going to use a normal coffee, and I'm going to say yes. Now, my phone is going to make the HTTP request and the coffee maker will prepare the coffee. And as you can see, the coffee is done. Thank you.